had a big mess, pretty much. We had a hungry toddler. The toddler was tired. Viola was tired. We went to an award ceremony, but left Benvolio home, and then he became tired. Gianna just kind of fell asleep. And now she's awake. She's the first one awake. Everyone, a round of applause for Gianna. I'm not clapping loudly because I don't want to annoy you guys with, like, loud clapping. Ah, that's the thing. She wants to perform an interaction I haven't done yet, and I'm surprised I haven't, which is talk about imaginary friend. I think she's going to talk about the imaginary friend with Benvolio, because Benvolio's a bit, you know, I feel like he would actually believe her. And everyone else kind of wouldn't. Sad truth, but I feel like she would get made fun of a bit for saying she had an imaginary friend. That's just kind of sadly how life is nowadays. But yeah, she's just a kid, so it makes more sense to them. They're like, oh, you'll grow out of it. It's just a phase. But when she's a teenager and she's talking to no one, oof. So how's you guys' day been? Mine's been pretty well. It's the same day as it was in my last episode, but you know, it's been pretty well. It's almost birthday. Wow, amazing. So after I did all that talk about, participation trophies, yeah, Anthony got a participation trophy. Oops, I think. So the school bus is coming in an hour, and no one's really awake yet. We're on the move, we're on the prowl, you know? Free the genie. No. Stop thinking about the genie or I'll sell it. Right, I figured out I can't sell the genie lamp. Fun fact, I was gonna sell it after making one last wish for money, but then it didn't let me. So forever in a money situation again, I'll make the wish, but that's about it. I still don't know if you guys approve of me doing that. Because I haven't posted the video where we even moved to this house yet. I was just excited to record, and can he, like, upgrade this to be shut up? He can. Nice. There goes Benny, heating up his breakfast. He did not get a good night's sleep at all. And I feel really bad, but at the same time I don't, because he is a dumb. So there. Oh, there's trash in there. Neato Frito. He's getting his breakfast started, though. And when you wake up, Ollie boy, you need to take a shime in the useless sauna. My favorite part. I showed my dad this house, and I was like, yeah, I was trying to go for, like, an Italian theme. And he was like, you did it. And I was like, thanks. I'm proud. That means so much to me. You're an engineer. Thank you. I mean, I think that if you look at it, you're like, wow, you don't know how to build. It's huge. Yeah, I've never been good at building houses. I usually build way too big, and then I have all this, like, excess space. But I guess it seems fitting with the, like, I guess, richness of this family. Or not richness, but, like, their... at least one of their jobs. And how they had so many kids, they probably do have a bit of money. Or else they couldn't really afford all these kids. And that would be kind of sad. But anyway, did you know there's a type of tile just called pool? And you can put it in your pool? I didn't know that. And she is hungry, she needs to use the bathroom, she needs to take a shower. I'm gonna send her to eat food before she does anything. But yeah, she basically passed out the second she got back home. So she's gonna come in here and eat leftover birthday cake. Uh-oh, there's only one day. It's a lot of money. Well, guys, it was nice having more than $10,000. But it's gone now. And she'll use this and take one of these. And Benny boy better be getting to school. The bus is gonna leave without him, and he doesn't know how to drive yet. Go. 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 Don't you dare clean that up. Go. If your mom or dad sees you, you're in big trouble, mister. I'm so weird with these Sims. I mean, not like weird, but like different than I treat my other Sims, if you get it. Get going, sir. Neither of you waking up to scold him. That's good. That's great. Gianna's gone. We're good. Also, somehow Anthony ended up on honor roll, which I think is pretty funny. How are you doing in school? You got a B? You got a B? No, you gotta work on that, don't ya? you gotta work on that, don't ya? I'm kidding. I'm totally a B student myself, so I get it. No, I'm less than a B student. Calculus! I don't even take calculus anymore. I've been put on a special program called... No. Gosh, I'm so tired. I'm sorry. It's like 11 p.m. I don't know, one time I was like, yeah, it's like 5 a.m. when I'm recording this. But I'm not as reckless as I used to be, I could say. I'm a little less rebellious with my choices. And I chose to sleep. I choose to sleep now. Surprise. I mean, I am pretty old. You know, 18. Old right there. but you know, I guess I just need more sleep because I've been so stressed lately that I either want to sleep or I just kind of want to get lost in playing The Sims. That's why I kind of record so much and so frequently, is because it's my, like, getaway. I used to actually run another Let's Play channel back in 9th grade, and it was kind of the same way then. When I had nothing else to really escape to, I would escape to my Let's Plays. And I used to do Nintendo Let's Plays. let's see, I did a Let's Play on Poke Park. I started one on Wind Waker. And I started one on Fire Emblem. But I quit Fire Emblem because of one of the characters that I liked, I accidentally let die. Because I'm terrible at video games, fun fact. I was just doing it for fun, though. And then when this character died, and someone told me, yeah, they're not coming back after you let them die in this game, I started crying while recording. So I was like, I had my headset on, I was like, he's gone forever. And so I was like sobbing. I don't do well with character deaths. Mm. So I'm like, please don't let them die during the Let's Play with Oliver and Viola. I know it's inevitable, but if I can avoid seeing it myself or like having it in this Let's Play, I have to prep myself, you know? And I feel like the more Let's Plays I do of this, the more I'll get used to it, because I'm gonna give you guys a secret. Every time I play The Sims, like in the past, when I first started playing, I told you guys the first expansion pack I had Supernatural. Well, I started off playing with a vampire and a witch, and when I realized the vampire had way more lifespan than the witch, I made my witch a vampire. And then I learned fairies have a long lifespan, so I started making every single Sim I made a fairy, just so I wouldn't have to play with them dying. I remember I cried the first time one of my Sims became an adult, because I realized they were one step closer to death, and I was like, ugh. I have had Sims die on me before, but it's never been from old age. Let's see, I've had a Sim die from Jelly Bean Tree, which was like a Sim I made after myself. And I was a dum-dum. I mean, it usually happens. Then I've had the Murphy Bed kill a Sim, and I loved that Sim. I had these triplets. No, I had these, I think it was twins. Yeah, I had twins, and I loved these twins so much. Like, I bawled my eyes out when he died, because he was just curled up there, you know, how they do? And I was, like, sobbing. I almost wanted to have his brothers come and, like, plead for him to come back alive. But I didn't. But then the save corrupted, and I had to restart from that day. And I replace the Murphy bed as soon as I was back in the game. So I felt like I was cheating a bit. But at the same time, I was like, ooh, I get to save my favorite. So I did. I saved my favorite. I know that's a weird story to tell. I'm just kind of telling you guys about my Sims experiences, I suppose. Let's see, what's other things I've done in the Sims? I boosted up the, like, lifespan to where young adults were 45 days. I've used the Young Again potion repeatedly to keep my Sims young, because I thought mermaids should have a longer life, so I did that with a mermaid sim. Ooh, Rosalinda, that's a pretty name. What else have I done? I've done so much to keep Sims alive. Like, you guys probably think it's ridiculous, but what are you doing? Go eat. But you know, it was my first... You can make pumpkin pie, but... Susie! Yes, Susie! Susie Santoro strikes again! I don't care if it's like... This was in the picture, but Susie! I introduced my dad to Susie when I was showing him the house, and he laughed in his first reaction to her, and I was like, Dad, that is our favorite Susie. I hope you guys love Susie as much as I do. Like, I feel like I'm always so weird when I'm like, oh yes, Susie, Susie. But I love Susie. She's my favorite. I've had several dogs in games. I guess to get back on track to what I was saying before. And I've only had one reach elder status, and I think that was sadder than any sim death I've had, because it was based off of a dog that I really wanted for a while. It was a Boston Terrier named Willie, and as you guys may or may not know, I have extreme anxiety to a point where sometimes I can't even leave the house. And I was like, I read that Boston Terriers are really good support animals, because I was like, I don't want to get a service animal. I don't want people to think, you know, anything like that. But I thought I could get an emotional support animal so that whenever I'm home or like in my dorm or whatever, I can have this dog there to make me feel, I guess, a bit, to feel a bit more secure with myself, I suppose. It's an odd thing, I know. You guys are probably like, that's weird, you're weird. But, yeah, so I was looking into it. I was trying to find where they sold Boston Terriers nearby. I was, like, so ready to have a Boston Terrier. But then I found out, like, no, you can't. Like, my parents basically told me, no, you can't have that. It, mainly because of money and because we already have a dog. But although my dog is, like, the opposite of an emotional support animal. Like, I looked up, like, the tests you have to put them through and all this fun stuff. And I was like, my dog can't do that. So, yeah, Susie has 11 days to being an elder, and I think that'll be sadder than anyone else becoming an elder. Sorry, Viola. I'm very excited for you to become an elder. You're gonna be a cute old lady. So we're gonna give Jace a bath, then potty train him, and probably empty the pooper. Alright, so the boys should be on their way home. I feel like this has been talk time with Ryan. Yeah, they're on their way home. They need some fun. Drum your way. Benny, you weirdo. I've been thinking about going in and changing Benvolio's name to just Ben, so I can stop being like, you know, Benvolio. I named my kid Benvolio. Oh yeah. Zojovo. Field trip. Get attention from aww. Just get through your field trip, Gianna. Stop being so sappy. And she got a thingy, my bobs. Let's look at it. I'm eloquent. Where can I put it? I filled up all her walls. Oopsie daisy. That's appropriate for a child, my bad. Oops, I filled up every single wall she owns. So we'll go put it in the hallway. Oh, nope, there's a space, there's a space, there's a space. She didn't get a souvenir. Thanks. Means a lot to me. And you need to do your homework. As soon as I know you're indoors. As soon as that little thing disappears, I'll let you do your homework. Yeah, do homework. This part's felt more energized. I guess because I'm talking more about, you know, my favorite person, me. I'm sorry. For people who don't know me, that probably sounded so conceited. And it was conceited, that's the thing. But it's not true, I promise. You found a seed? How cool. We're gonna put up your graveyard pose. Graveyard poke. Okay, we can't. We're gonna put it out in the hallway. That fits in. I love it. Wow. Looks great in our hallway. We did it. We have that in the hallway now. Good. Let's see this. Cavernous adventure. Exploring the mausoleum was utterly terrifying and total adrenaline. I can't speak right now. I guess no one has any award ceremonies tonight. That's good, that's good. Benvolio's just gonna come home and nap, in all honesty. He's tired. He's worn out. He's, like, out of it. Did you eat your pumpkin pie? You're eating anchovies. You made a pumpkin pie, and you're eating sushi rolls? Where's your pumpkin pie? Where's the pumpkin pie? Where's the pumpkin pie? Where is it? Oh, please tell me you put it away as leftovers. Oh my gosh. Oh, if our house is about to burn down. Or it's just gone? Okay. This is fine. I suppose you did your homework, so you can come reward yourself with eating. Yeah, just come get some food, and you do need to eat before you go to sleep. By sleep, I mean you're gonna nap, because today is an important day. Oops, it's raining, it's pouring, the old man is snoring. It's not really an important day, but I can pretend. You don't have work tonight, so can you just clean the house? Me. You don't have work! Clean the house. And then you can nap. You, how are you? You're riding your bike home? Oh. Oh. Poor babe. I feel bad for her. But at the same time, I mean, it's probably fun. She's probably having fun. Biking all the way home. You're gonna have some birthday cake for dinner. Yeah. And then just take a shower. Wait, no, this is your last night as a kid. Oh, and then we won't have a child until Jace ages up. God, Jace. You're so dumb. Going to submarine adventure. How are you doing? You're doing great. Mom, how are you doing? You'd like to be having more fun. Well, how about you go to the exercise area, gym thing, and, do the exercise. Do some chin-ups, it'll be fun. And don't bring a sweat. Neeb, neeb. You're just cleaning. I like you. I like you, Oliver Santa. But yeah, I had an idea with what I want to do with the last baby's name. What I've decided is you guys name two. I name two. I'm going to randomize the last name. What? But that's cheating. You can't just randomize a name. I am. But you guys can name the grandchild, if there is one. If Anthony and Michaela decide, yeah, let's make a baby. You guys can name that one. I'm being nice. And then you can come work out, because it's like your day off. You can do that. Tomorrow's spooky day, so they're all probably gonna go trick-or-treating or something. I don't know yet, because we will have a child for at least half the day. So they might go early in the day to go do it, but you know. I don't know yet. How's Jace doing? Jace is still doing great. Playing with a... sheep? Sheep. React to pet. What's pet doing? Guarding an object. Pet, you're tired. Pet. Hello, pet. Puppet. Oh, we know that's an actual word. I was thinking about, like, you know that, like, that one, like, it's not a pet name. It's not a pet name. It's like, isn't it an insult or, like, something? The poppet thing? You know, like, that cliche, hello, poppet! I'm offending people now. I was trying to be a funny and say puppet instead because Susie's a pup. But then I realized puppet is already a word. And I'm just dumb. Are you not coming to nap? Come nap. Come nap. Come do it. Come on. Don't be a dumb. Come nap. I really hope someone, like, just quotes me every day from now on. Don't be a dumb. Don't do drugs either. Those aren't good. I can't believe I said puppet. It's a real word. I'm a dumb. Don't worry, guys. After you're done... Who? Who's that? Who's Alrigo? Why are you mourning them? They don't matter. Whoever they are. Yeah, look at these two working out together. How great. Amazing workout. How sweet the sound or something. Oh, she's so wet. Oh no. Then serve dinner. Serve up some. Some wood-fired lasagna. That sounds good. I like lasagna. Actually, I hate lasagna. I've mentioned this many times, but I do not like lasagna. I believe that's it for this part, because we have her working out, him cleaning the house, him working out. Oh, don't work out until 1:30 a.m. Well, you don't want to stay up past your bedtime, so I guess we can work out a little bit longer. Let's go watch her have her very last submarine adventure. We're gonna watch a little girl take a bath. Pizza ha! Pizza ha! Wait! I know what I never did. You guys haven't really seen the toddler-child interactions. She's gonna come and play peekaboo with him after she's done taking her bath. But let's watch. Let's watch this bath. I'm sure it'll be magical. A submarine adventure. Yep, this is it. Oh, and there's sometimes magic noises. Secret Agent G. Level 5! Yay! Alright, go ahead and stop. I feel like this part's gonna be a little bit longer, and I do apologize for that. But I guess it's just there's so much to cover. And it's just fun to play The Sims 3. So there. Oh. I'm playing it. And then she can eat some leftover Mania Calzone. Alright, yeah, you go ahead and stop. You're tired. Stop, Liz. Please stop. And then you can come and sleep. He just finished napping, but he's gonna sleep after he's done. Oops. She is still taking a bath. But once she's done with that, she's gonna go sleep. I keep saying, like, I'm gonna end the part off now, but wait, she has her cousin Cousin hair in the bath? Oh, but she has messed up eyebrows. Was it you? Did you do- you broke the- did she just stretch? After you're done doing the thing, can you repair this? Thanks. Anyway, so here's the child-toddler interactions. Yeah, he doesn't need to do that anymore. So here's the child-toddler interaction. Of a peekaboo. Oh, look, they're gaining... Kookie-choo means peekaboo in Simlish. Anyway, I'm going to end this part off here. If you liked it, why not go ahead and like it? If you didn't like it, go and give it a thumbs down, but please tell me why. If you enjoyed, why not subscribe? And if this wasn't your cup of tea, don't feel obliged to do anything. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Goodbye!